for basically cleansing the world of the inferior people. It is an inherently elitist understanding that sees no value or intrinsic worth except in those lives that stand up to the measuring rod of these elitists as somehow valuable to humankind. In one respect, it turns out that as the left-wingers move down this road, they are implementing a dehumanizing understanding. But instead of dehumanizing people based on the racist notions of somebody like Hitler and the things that were being portrayed in Germany, they dehumanize people based on the scientific understanding that there's nothing essentially human about us, that we are, in that sense, just blobs of flesh and chemicals and junk that can be manipulated like any other physical thing. And that, of course, means that there's no boundaries whatsoever that you have to respect except the whimsical boundaries of personal attachment, so that if you're part of the favored clique, you might be treated differently. That's the world they're pushing us toward. And abortion was essentially the cutting edge to get people implicated in a moral understanding that destroyed our sense that humanity and every single human being have a moral worth that must be respected by the power of government, that can't be disregarded on the basis of some elitist measuring rods of who's worth having around and who can be killed with impunity.
Ambassador, isn't this really the religion of control freaks on power trips, where Peter Singer says, let parents kill their babies for a year after they're born, get rid of the old people, they've got the same value as mackerel. I mean, these are quotes saying an old person has the same value as a fish, that a retarded child needs to be killed. And I found they really are the ultimate racist, as Margaret Sanger wrote in her own letters to W.D.B. Du Bois. You know, she said, I've got to hire black men to be my fronts to get rid of these black weeds. In my research, I found that the real racist, the real Nazis, always cloak themselves as liberals, and that it's even more than that. It's not just some pseudoscience and their excuse to play God, that they ravenously enjoy going after Asians, Africans, Latin Americans, poor people. It doesn't matter. And that they even have people of color in their ranks who enjoy this.
Well, you know, the sad thing is, underlying it all, there is an element of what I call self-worship involved in this, that is involved in the fascination these elites have for themselves and their own power, and the confirmation they see when they enjoy a little success that somehow they're better than everybody else. That even, by the way, accounts for their so-called compassion, because it affirms their superiority to see themselves from a height, helping the downtrodden who, because of their inferiority, couldn't do as well, and so forth and so on. But remember, that kind of self-worship has an implication that goes to the very heart of religion and faith and spirituality, because it denies that there is anything other than themselves that is worthy of that kind of real reverence. And so it is premised at the end of the day on the banishing of God from the consciousness of human beings. And that's why people like myself, who put a great stress on the American Declaration, on the fact that our unalienable rights come from the hand of Almighty God, we are their deep enemy, because we will not let people forget the existence of God and the fact that most of us accept that and believe it.
Well, Ambassador, when you read, as I know you have, as being all these futurists and transhumanists and neo-eugenicists that just fill the government ranks, the Dr. Piankas and the Holdrens and Ehrlichs, they actually believe their God. In the BBC, there was a report last year where they said, we're going to split off and be an elite species of the government planner, and then all the rest of you are these subhumans. I mean, you're right. But it's not just that they don't want to say God doesn't exist. They're saying, I am God.
Well, you see, but I think that's a return to something quite old in terms of human injustice. Remember that when the people of the world were subjected to these old oligarchic aristocratic regimes, you know, the nobles and the peasantry and all of this, the myths of the time were centered on apotheosis. That is, where the elite, because of their success and achievements and greatness, they are elevated to the status of God. That happened to the Caesar. That happened to others. The aim, therefore, in that pagan understanding was for these people to transform themselves to God-like status. And all we're seeing is a return of that age-old shibboleth. Now being used once again to impose the idea of some kind of inherent superiority of these elites upon people whom they intend en masse to oppress.
Amazing. Ambassador, we've got to have you back up on this subject. Last question. Governors oppose DOD emergency powers. That's from The Hill, newspaper in D.C., as you know. Congressman could use pandemic to declare martial law. Congressman told the Louisville Journal. Congressman Paul Brown said they may use it to declare martial law as a cover for Obama because his agenda. Pentagon wants authority to post 400,000 military personnel in the U.S. I mean, this is unbelievable. And we now hear Obama saying terrorist, right-wing terrorist, and the Southern Poverty Law Center, you know, and the DOD documents, and the Justice Department, Homeland Security, veterans and gun owners and Ron Paul supporters are terrorists. In the last 2 minutes, can you comment on that? And are you concerned that Obama may stage crises, as Michael Savage and others have said?
Well, I think we're seeing again a reliable pattern that was there in the 20th century versions of this imposition of communism, the blurring of the distinction between the military and law enforcement, the destruction of the idea that human beings have individual rights. Instead, there's some national security threat that overrides those rights and justifies making use of any kind of action against individuals if you can put them in a category as a national security threat. I warned against this for many years, and we are now seeing it brought to full fruition. And finally, I think there is the mentality that we now know was there, for instance, with the Nazis. The famous turning point in terms of the consolidation of Hitler's power was the burning of the Reichstag, which they blamed on the communists and leftists and those who were opposing what Hitler was trying to do. And what we now know from the historical record, they did it themselves. They burned down the Reichstag in order to provoke the excuse that allowed them to impose that totalitarian control and consolidate it completely over Germany. I think that we're watching a repetition of this pattern, and we need to wake up, and we need to use those tools we still have available as Americans to stop this from happening.
Amazing. Ambassador Alan Keyes, I look forward to having you back up. The website is loyaltoliberty.blogspot.com. Thank you so much, sir.
Glad to be with you. Thanks for having me.
Thank you, sir.
For listening to GCN.
Finally in the news this evening, it's being reported that cyber spies from Russia and China have now penetrated our power grid. Even as energy experts are reporting that each summer we get closer and closer to the limits of our nation's power grid, some say that this summer's demand for electrical power may finally push the grid over its edge, creating a cascade of power outages across the country, putting us all in the dark.
Are you prepared for the next round of storm-related outages or government-created blackouts? Have you ever thought about taking steps to get off the grid and generate your own private supply of electrical power? If so, this will be the most important information you have ever heard. Solar-powered generators are finally available. They have no moving parts to wear out or break and require absolutely no gas whatsoever. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Check out mysolarbackup.com before you lose your power.